Hi there, welcome to WebAppPick. In this video, we'll be learning how to upload products into Facebook Business Manager by using our plugin CTX Feed. Please note that you can actually manually upload products onto Facebook Business Manager. However, in this video, we'll be focusing on uploading a lot of products in bulk by using a feed. In this case, we'll be using CTX Feed. Right now, let's go ahead and create a new feed. Click on Make Feed. Now you'll be redirected to this page. In this page, you'll have to set up the country you're creating this feed for. In this case, let's choose United States. Now we already have a lot of preset templates for you guys. In this case, we'll be choosing Facebook catalog / Instagram. Let's choose that. Let's name our file My FB Feed 1. We're going to keep the feed type as XML and the item wrappers and the single item wrapper as products and product respectively. Since we have chosen the template Facebook catalog / Instagram, we'll see that the feed config that we have are already populated with Facebook attributes for the feed. Now, let's look at a few of these attributes. As you can see here, we have Google product category. Right now, we have set it as pattern, assuming that all the products that we'll be uploading will be under the same Google product category. In this case, I have chosen apparel and accessories. You can learn about all the different Google product categories by actually Googling Google product category list, which will give you all the different categories that are available within Google. Now, for your convenience, we have already pre-populated all the different categories within our plugin. So all you have to do is just search up the category you're looking for and just choose that. Let's look at a few other attributes. Right now, we can see regular price and sales price. Now, in the suffix, we can see that it is pre-populated with GBP, which is Great Britain Pound. Since you're using US as a country of sale in this example, we're going to change them to USD, US dollar. Moving forward, we can see manufacturer brand. I have currently set this as pattern, which will return us with a static value. We can rename this to whatever we want. I will rename this to my brand. So every single product we'll be uploading will have the brand my brand. At this point of time, let's keep the rest of the attributes as they are. And we're going to go ahead and click on update and generate feed. This will only take a few seconds and we'll see that our feed is generated and ready to go. This is the feed URL that we will be pushing onto Facebook when we're ready. You'd ideally want to log into your Facebook Business Manager. So I'll give you a few seconds as you log into your account. Facebook also calls it Facebook Business Suite. Now, after you have logged in, you want to make sure you have chosen the correct account. After that, on the sidebar, you want to click on Commerce. You will be redirected to this page. In this page, you want to scroll down to Catalogs. Under Catalogs, you want to choose any existing catalogs that you have, or if you want, you can create a new catalog by clicking on this button. I will choose the product catalog that I already have. After I've done that, you can see my catalog has come up. Now under suggestions, you can add items in bulk. And this is exactly what we're gonna use because we'll be using CTX feed and the feed that we have generated to upload our items. I'm gonna click on add items. After that, as you can see, there are all different choices for you to upload your file. You can add it manually, use bulk upload, use a partner platform, or you can use Pixel. In this case, we'll be using a bulk upload. We'll also be using a schedule feed to put our feed up at a certain point in time every day. I'm going to go ahead and click on next. After I've done that, as you can see, as I told you, we've got all these options. We've got file upload where you just singularly upload a file, or you can schedule a feed, or you can use Google Sheets at the same time as well. In this case, I want to choose schedule feed because I want my feed to constantly get updated at a certain point in the time of the day. I'm going to go ahead and click on next. Now we have come to the main bit where it's asking us to set up the feed. This is where we'll be entering the URL we have generated using CTX feed. So let's go there. This is my feed. I'm just going to click here and copy it. I'm going to go back and I'm going to paste this right here. After that, if your data is sensitive, if you want, you can use a username and password to protect it. In this case, I will just leave this as blank as this is optional. I'm going to go ahead and click next. And right now it's asking us, when exactly do you want to schedule your updates? I'm just going to keep it as it is. If you want, you can change this time to your convenience. And I'm going to go add next. Now it is asking to name the data source where we are receiving our data from. As you can see, the software automatically pre-populates it with the site IP address that we are receiving our data from. I'm going to change this and make it a little bit easier. My website feed. I'm going to keep it at that. We're going to keep it as US dollars because that's where we'll be selling our products to. After clicking on upload, this is going to take some time. As you can see, your products are finally being uploaded into Facebook Manager. As you can see, everything is going through smoothly. So far, so good. There are 12 products that is found and 12 products that has been updated. There are no errors yet and no products have been removed so far. This is what the page will look like after the upload is complete. As we can see, we have 12 products that has gone up, 12 products that has gone up here with no errors whatsoever. Now the next time the feed is going to be updated again or uploaded is when we have scheduled it. However, we can always force it to be uploaded again by clicking on upload now, going down and request update now. Once you do that, as you can see, the file will immediately be uploaded again. You'd want to do this when you have made some changes to your feed file and you want those changes to take effect immediately. Right now, we have just witnessed a successful upload of all the products with no errors whatsoever. However, in an ideal world, it's not always this perfect. Sometimes when you're trying to upload our feed, we end up with errors. Right now, let me go back to my website and intentionally create some errors so that you can look like when an error message is being produced when you're trying to upload your feed. I'm going to go back to my website. Let's choose this hoodie. I'm going to go quick edit and I'm going to delete the prices that it has. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to hit update. Now, as you can see, this hoodie has no price whatsoever. I'm going to go back to CTX feed. I'm going to go manage feed. I'll find my feed, my Facebook feed one, and I'll regenerate this feed. Now, because prices are a mandatory component, when I try to upload this back in Facebook, I am expecting to see some issues. As expected, you can see after the upload is complete, there is some errors that we can see right here. Now we can see that one of the product has been rejected. We know exactly why, because it's missing prices. But let's click on view report and let's look at what the software is telling us. As you can see here, you can tell in line 218 ID 35 hoodie is missing prices. If you want, you can also download this report. So I'm going to close this and I'm going to go back and rectify the issue. So right now I'm going to go back to my website. I'm going to go back to products. I'm going to find the hoodie, go to quick edit and say it's $30 and that's the SKU. That's $30 here and $25 price. Let's update it. Let's go back to CTX feed, regenerate our feed so that it takes effect. And right now we're going to go back into Facebook and we're going to upload this file again. Voila! Just like that, we have fixed the issue once again. Now, if you're having any issues when you're trying to upload your feed into Facebook and you're facing some error messages you can't fix, you're more than welcome to go ahead and reach out to us. Please email us at support@webepic.com. I hope you have found this video useful. Please like and subscribe for more videos like this. I hope you have a great day. Thank you very much.